This next feature, on a scale of 1 to 10, I suppose where 10 is the most important and most often used, this would be about a 2. It's a very obscure feature. It rarely comes in handy, but when it does come in handy, it can absolutely save the day. It basically allows you to get access to the VBE. VBE is the Visual Basic Editor itself. You can get access to it programmatically. Now this is nothing new for ProcessBook. Any good ActiveX control container with scripting should be able to do that. I'll give you an example of how you might use this. See, I've got a bunch of buttons here. Now let's just pretend I don't just have 3 buttons, I've got 300 buttons. And they're on multiple displays. And I know there's a lot of code that's fairly similar from one button to the next that I need to insert into the code panels that go with these buttons, the click events. Well, as you can see right now, there is nothing associated with this button. I click on this and nothing at all happens. What I would like to do is I would like to insert the proper code into those buttons. Okay? Well, I can do that by running a little script. I'm going to run a script called test1. And as if by magic, notice all of a sudden it works. We're selecting the right colors. I'm now going to select similar objects. It's selecting all the squares. Now we'll select all the circles. And the reason we can do this is because at this point, basically what we've done is we've inserted code into those code panels. So if I look at the Visual Basic here, here are my command buttons. The command buttons previously, let's show these again. The command buttons previously had no code, but now the code's been inserted in there. And it's been inserted by getting access to the VB editor. Here's the code that we use to add things to this, to these code panels right here. Now what we're doing is we're dimensioning a variable, myVBE, as the Visual Basic Editor. We get access to that by simply saying myVBE is, well, we're establishing a reference to the current ProcessBook application's VBE editor, application.vbe. Now that gives us the Visual Basic Editor. We need to find the individual code panes. This entire, what we're looking at here is a code pane, and what we're doing is going into myVBE. It has a code panes collection. We're going to get the first item in that, and the first item we're going to go into the code module. Okay. And using a with statement, we're saying everything that happens within here is going to be done to this particular code module. So we're looking at the individual items, refining the items using this proc body line, code module dot proc body line. We're finding that item, that line number, and then we're doing an insert lines using that line number that we've derived from this command up here. So we're inserting lines, select color, select light, and list objects. That's how these bits of code got added to that command button. So if you recall before, when I clicked on the buttons, nothing happened. Afterwards, this was inserted in there, so it ran the appropriate subroutines, which are also included in this example. So that's an example of how we can get access to the VBE. If you've got some kind of a project where you really need some kind of a code generator to edit thousands of links or what have you, this is a great way to go about it. Here's another idea on how you can make use of this feature. In many cases, people, when they find out how much work they have to do basically to make references to individual files, like if I want to go out and find or browse for that file called myutils.pdi, people just don't want to have to do all that work for hundreds of displays. And here's an example of how we can use the VBE editor to basically add references. There is something called the Active VB project that has a references collection, and you can do an add method. It says add from file. You simply use the name of the PDI file that will be added as a reference. So to show you before and after, right now I don't have any references to my utils right here. I'll go ahead and execute this couple of lines of code by pressing F8 and stepping through it. And at that point, as you can see, it just went ahead and made the reference. And if I go into Tools References, oops, wrong application now. Let me go ahead and complete that. If I go into Tools References, there it is. We've programmatically made a reference to that. So if you are looking at lots of shared code and you don't want to have to do that all by hand, here's a programmatic solution.